Hey y'all, y'all doing all right? We doing okay right now. Well, what I'm fixing to do is here all the way over to there, which I mean, it's all pretty much cleared out right there. We went and got a storage building, bought one, and it's gonna be delivered sometime. I don't know when, but whenever. So I got to clear all this out here. This brush, this is where I had some trees cut down. That's gonna become firewood. But anyways, I got to get all this here cleared out. And that way I have plenty of room because it's 24 foot long. As y'all can see, it's a pretty good little project. I'm gonna have to get out the saw and all that. This here was done by fellow by the name of Caleb Blankenship. He done a good job. He done some stuff up there for me. He cut them down for me, gave me a good price. Can't complain. Anyways, we're gonna get all this cleared out today. Cut down this tree here. And then I gotta cut down that tree there next to the propane tank. And I got a little cedar tree in there. I'm not sure if that's elm or, I think it's elm tree or hickory. I think it's elm. So we gotta cut them out and maybe make firewood out of those. We're gonna be getting the big old Echo out here in a little bit. I gotta move all this PVC pipe from me running the water line from the road up here from my water meter. It's about, 500 feet. So anyways, I gotta get this. I'm gonna put it over there behind my shed and get it out of the way. You never know when you need some more PVC, you know what I mean? But that's what we got planned for today. Tomorrow, you know, I got some medical issues. Apparently, I got a leaking brain stem somewhere. So, tomorrow they're gonna inject dye in my spine and see if they can't see where it's coming out, leaking at. So we got that tomorrow. And after that, they told me I'd take it easy for at least a day or two. Whatever, I'm gonna try to listen to them. It's gonna be hard because I just don't like sitting around. Just ain't in me. But anyways, we're gonna get this project started. I'm gonna try to catch a little footage of it, and there we go. Well, we got the tractor started. We got the saw gassed up. I forgot to video that. There's a saw. It's an Echo CS7310P 32 inch bar. That's my bar oil and fuel all in one, with my file and my scrunch and all that in one. I seen it on Stony Ridge Farmer one day. I was like, heck yeah, that there is handy. I'm telling you, it's nice to have everything kind of one. It's got a little toolbox here on the side. I mean, not sponsored or nothing, but I bought this with my own money. I've had it for a couple years. Got my marker in there when I'm sharpening, my gauge and my grease for my bar tip and stuff. But we fixed to drop the forks off of the Branson, Brandy to Branson, and we're gonna go and hook up the grapple. Show y'all what I did over here right quick. So when them rounds are, I went and cut one of these totes. It's a little bit more open. I'm using it like a pickup bed, I guess, in a way. Stack that wood up in it when it's real heavy, because I can just roll them big pieces, and then as they get smaller, I can stack them up and get them up there at waist high. I'm gonna give that a shot, see how that works out. Plus, it'll be good off in the woods, bring wood out. A thought process on that. But yeah, we're gonna get started on getting this cleared out. Move, you know, just brush moves and stuff. And get ready for the storage building coming in, because, well, it's just things we got to do around here. All right, team. Well, y'all, I got the grapple hooked up finally. As y'all can see, I had to loosen up these two lines here. Get the pressure off so I can put these on. And, but this is the grapple. Pretty good size TerraForce, man. I'm going to tell y'all, this thing here. I think it's right there. think the weight, I don't know if the weight's on there or not, but I'm gonna tell y'all.
It's pretty good little rake. I've had it for a minute, about a year. And I pushed trees over with it. To be honest, I'm surprised it's not bent, but give me a minute. So anyways, we got that on. Fixing to go, I was up on that gravel, man. And I was like standing up trying to push a man. I come off of it right before I decided, well, I'm gonna loosen these lines and get this pressure off. And hit my knee on that iron. Ooh. I almost said something awful. It's close though. I'm gonna have a bruise in the morning. But anyway, it is what it is. But yeah, we fixing to get back up on here. We're gonna get the saw loaded up. We're gonna head over there and buck that up, cut down a few trees and get it all out of the way and get ready for the storage bin to come in. The storage bin's for my wife and my daughter. It's gonna be their spot. Or we're gonna raise chickens in it and then show chickens. And then we're gonna take, after the show chickens, we'll take them out. We'll use it for what we need around the place and stuff. This here's my tiller. It's a 72 inch tiller, 6 foot, whatever. It's a good old tiller, man. It's TerraForce. Old boy sold that to me, good price. Can't complain, it's used. Had a little bit of damage in it, on it, but I'm gonna tell you, if you run across a deal, you run across a deal. Yeah, it's a little bit bent. It may not make the most beautiful tilled piece of land, I don't know. It does a good job. It does what it's supposed to do. It's supposed to tell. I had to make a modification to it. Went and had to go get one of these. I got that from Tractor Supply, which y'all know what that is, slip clutch. And then the rest of it, this part here I got from Tractor Supply. And that yoke up there I got off old Bush Hog I got. That one right up here. An old Bush Hog I inherited. And shoot, man, sucker works, boy. Tear up the ground, I'm telling you. You can plant tomatoes after you're done with it. I ain't nothing wrong with it, I tell you. It's a good old tiller. I like it. It's a reverse tie, so it blows it forward. So that's a pretty good job. But anyhow, we're going to get on this thing. We're going to get the saw, like I said. I repeat myself a lot. I'm at that age where I do that, so get used to it. And we're going to get to work. tell y'all what, y'all can say what you want to, but I believe a 32-inch bar is about the only way to go. My back sure don't hurt. And I've ran that thing all day cutting stuff. It's nice not having that. Been way over. Anyway, we're gonna take, get the tractor fired up, we're gonna take all this, we're gonna push it over here, out of the way. And make room for the building. The building's probably gonna come about right here. Lengthwise, we'll probably down that way, but about where that tree is right there, we're gonna put that down next. And yeah.
Thank you. hell?
I don't baby it. I know that some of y'all probably watching going, oh my God, he's gonna tear that thing to pieces. I'm gonna tell y'all, that's a tough old tractor. I've done a lot of things with that thing that I don't know if they meant for it to do it, but it does it. All right, we finished cut this elm tree down. I think I'm gonna put a notch in it and kind of cut on the backside and push it yonder away. So it's kind of lean towards my propane.
Can y'all see that?
Thank you.
Well, my idea of kind of pushing it over there, we got an old pond over there. Kind of filling it up. It used to be, they drilled a well a long time ago, gas well. And back then they used to have them reserve pits, and that's where it's pond there, but I'm filling up with brush. Anyways, we're gonna take and buck that up. I thought I could just shove it over there, but it ain't working out too good, so I'm gonna cut it up. Because when they bring that shed in here, they're gonna come right through here, and then they're gonna place it just right on the other side of the camera. Anyway, we're gonna get the salt.
Ah!
tell you what, I by no means am a professional. Don't do as I do, or as, you know, yada, yada, yada. But I may have enough space for the storage building here shortly. And if we got that bucked up, cut up a little bit, maybe I could take it and pull them logs out and throw that brush up in there, up in that pile there. You know, I got a big old sweet gum tree over there. I got to basically get sawed up, split stuff. I got a couple big old pines too. Make some bonfire wood out of. Anyhow, I'm going to get back with you. Tell y'all, that grapple is about the handiest thing to ever have on the tractor. Like a pocket on the shirt. It just works. Anyway. Yeah, I know. I could probably pick this up and get it out of the way. Still got it done. Yada, yada, yada. Yeah, that'll be a pretty good thing. Anyways, we're going to cut this stuff off.
Well, me and the wife's gonna measure it up. See if we got I got everything cleared out enough where we get that shed in here. And we're gonna call it a day.